already, I mean, I have more than 30, almost 40 years experience of driving. Driving cars, driving trucks, driving van, driving bus. Train, yeah, I can drive. I mean, all sort of data, right? And then, about me already, I want to know about you. Your name, just now you said your name, driving experience, being involved in accident. For myself, I happened to be one time, lah. Bukan accident with anybody, but suddenly my car skipped. Because of somewhere they had, I'm coming back from Kuantan using the Katong to Bao. In between there, there's a straight road. So they had to slow me down. I misjudged the thing. Jadi dia masuk slow tu, the tail pergi ke bawah. Then I skip. Tak kena serta pula. Syukur Alhamdulillah tak kena serta pula. Sorry, but don't say, oh, sorry, sorry, this is my fault. No, you don't say anything. Relax a little bit, and I'll get tired and let the other people do, oh, we say this. And you have to take care of yourself. That would be very aggressive, and you can become very aggressive.
Yeah, in Malaysia, I mean, being lady driver, usually if you get involved with, sorry, but men, usually they be like very aggressive.
Okay, thank you so much.
I don't have more driving experience with car. That's mostly I drive motorbike for almost like 20 years, and in that I had one accident while turning, like the motorbike wheel got jammed there. I was unable to turn back, so then I jumped off the vehicle. I had minor scratches, that's all. And on the car, I probably like took my license in Thailand when I was in Thailand, but did not drive
when
much.
When was that?
No, it's still active. I have tried Thailand 2-3 years ago. But after that, I don't have a car, so I did not like practice or do anything there.
You don't
but
like to drive, right? You don't like to drive.
No, I like to drive, but because like since I'm expert and I don't have long term contract in any place, like unless it's 1 year or 2 years. Every time when I think of buying car, like it's just for what, there is no long term visibility, so I never plan for a car. That's all. But I like to drive. In Thailand also, we used to hire a vehicle and drive sometimes. Never owned any car, so in car I don't have much experience.
Some people, they don't like to drive, they like people to drive for them. They never want to touch the steering wheel, they don't like. I used to come across with these people that they have a car, but they don't drive the car. They have some years, I mean, they have a driver, or they have their wife, or the son.
And here also I'm trying, like now, currently my driving license application in process.
When you work here, I mean, you in here, you're completely required to drive?
No, I have to apply for driving license, so yes. I applied it. So just waiting for the practical written exam.
I see.
Been going for like 3-4 months, I don't know.
But the license in you get from Thailand,
they said cannot convert here. I'm not sure like whether people are like trying
to. If you have that license from any country,
yeah.
When you come to other country, you can get like a permit, driving permit, international IDP, they call it, international driving permit.
I had international driving permit which got expired. Like before that, I was not aware. Like I had to extend it here, but it was just for 1 year. I had an international driving license, a permit that got expired. But when I went with the Thailand driving license to the driving school, they told cannot. I have to redo everything. I don't know.
My name is Sufian. I've been driving since I was 16 years old. So even before I had a license.
Happened to me also.
Yeah. I took my dad's car out at night, so he doesn't know. So
still?
No.
Zero incident?
His car is zero incident. But with the car that I drove myself, the one that he gave to me, I've got, you know, like twice. So during my university days, I was half asleep and driving in the wet while rushing to class. So I went off road. But luckily, I didn't hit anyone.
Yeah, it's a single vehicle accident.
And then the second time was also in a wet condition. I was rushing back home. Spun the car and hit the curb, and all my engine oil went off. Luckily, also didn't involve anyone. And then after that, I told myself, look, I have to stop this. I don't drive like this. I have to value life more. So now I have a wife and kids. I drive more maturely.
Thank you, Joseph.
Hi, I'm Isudin. So yeah, I've been driving since I was 17 as well, I think about 10 years now. And I had one experience in accident last year. So basically we were in Ipoh, supposed to attend my cousin's wedding. and that was at, I think, 12:30 in the night, because we were driving back from a homestay where the family stayed into our homestay. So that was a straight line. And we were driving, and there's a traffic light that's green on our side. But suddenly there's a motorbike that just came in, so he like braked the traffic light, like, mm-hmm. So we hit the motorbike.
So what happened to the?
Luckily, just some minor injuries. So my expectation is, even though sometimes we are cautious, there's potential, because of other people, there's potential for us to involve in accidents as well. So I think we can learn more. So the experience I had with that guy, when we hit him, so first thing we did was we got out from the car and asked him if he's okay. So he just like say sorry, I langgar the traffic light and everything. And then suddenly a lot of his friends come. Suddenly they tak salah. So I'm the one who langgar the traffic light. Because I mean, he's local, I'm not local at that place. So they macam got his friend and all.
Yeah.
So I think one thing that I can learn from that is that always put your dash cam lah. I haven't had dash cam yet at that time.
Nowadays dash cam have long. Macam saya kita boleh nampak in the YouTube there are people trying to
manipulate.
No, manipulate, I think.
Oh, and one more thing, that guy doesn't have driving license. His motorbike doesn't have insurance.
Wow.
And I think all fault are coming towards him lah. Memang all salah towards him lah.
Malaysian.
But again, whoever fault pun, also,
and on our side, we have to claim our insurance
go to Balai, do the report, everything, you know. When you go to Balai, you know, the investigation officer, I told you, they call it. They have so many. So they ask you to wait. Let's say you're at the 9 in the morning, I think most probably you'll end up at 5 or 6 p.m. Kalau tidak, sometimes they say, okay, you punya case apa? You know, not the IO, no? The other sergeant ke apa ke datang. So you check up with your engineer. Okay, you guys, dua ni pergi settle sini. Ya, so settle. Mereka tu lagi besar case lagi ada yang IO sedang handle. So kalau you nak juga, you tunggu lah. So, bukan, we cannot blame them also, because
for my case tu macam our NCD gone lah. We never had accident before that. But because of that, and we cannot claim to that guy because doesn't have insurance, doesn't have license. So terpaksa claim to our insurance and NCD gone lah.
You sir?
Yeah, last but not least, my name is Zul. I started driving after SPM juga, but I'm 42 now, so 35 years of driving experience. I was in the UK from 2005 until last year December, and came back to Malaysia. So, have you ever been involved in an accident? No, alhamdulillah. But yeah, I consider myself a defensive driver. I think the road designs in UK is also better, signage are better, that helps with driving conditions and helps avoid accidents.
You can see after this, I mean, that's what we should do.
And
you face when you go.
And then whenever I come back to Malaysia for holidays, like every 1 or 2 years, and I always have to tukar macam badan kebal sikit nak drive kat Malaysia. That you have to change that mentality. And I feel like in the 3 months I've been driving in Malaysia, I'm turning into an offensive driver.
I think
that question, have you ever been in an accident? If I was in Malaysia, I'd have a credit. I'm just lucky. So my expectation is I want to be reminded how to be a defensive driver. Also on a serious note, one of my ex-schoolmates passed away last year. Due to a road accident, he was driving a motorcycle, and it's not due to his fault. And so on a serious note, I think whenever I drive, whenever I see motorcyclists cutting across, you know, I feel like it's my responsibility to protect him as well. So it's a life and death situation, so we have to be mindful of, you know, these are people's friends and sons or dads or, you know, wives and, you know, family. So that that's my explanation lah.
You have that quality of a good driver, you know. Is it one of the quality to become a good driver is a responsibility. You have to have I think the experience of that just you have to have a responsibility for yourself and for others. When you have that, we can actually our route today we become more safe for that we really have that thing. Okay?
Tapi senang nak marah. That's an issue. I'm not joking. Memang 3 bulan dah
habis. Weather pun ada main
dah. Exactly, agree. Ya.
Actor for weather because keep, kan? Kita ni ada. Okay. Actually, driving is a privilege. Bukan rights up. Yeah? Driving is a privilege. You have to abide with all the regulation, road traffic regulation, the highway code rating. Kalau you langgar, you kena tiket, your license will be revoked, apa semua. Kena gantung apa semua, then your privilege tak jalan untuk drive. But rights different, right? Like, there is lah. Can anybody ask, cakap, you tak boleh kahwin. You can get married. Can you have a family? It's alright. How did a hard work? But driving, people can take away from you. It's a privilege. Okay. Training objective we have achieved is to demonstrate and apply safe driving technique. And we're going to, I'm going to go through with you to use the WIN defensive driving technique of the days. These gain knowledge and understand the identifying hazard and risk of vehicle feature, why consequences, why we need to drive safely, and the consequences of not driving safely. We know the consequences. So with the training and understand the fatigue, which I need to manage by the fact. Sorry, pasal tambah tadi kan ada gambar yang korporat tu tapi sebenarnya itu tapi belum tetapi belum apa just to itu lah expectation of this training is start, dia di situ video. Ini pun not sure whether you guys have seen this video yet. Actually, the other side of the road when you are coming into your lane, while you are driving, the van will be caught. And what you said just now, the dash cam, yeah, was captured by this car, you know, just came up. But believe me, the real happened. Okay, Tapa, if you have any idea about this picture, at the end of this classroom meeting, we will go back to this video. After we go through all the system as it has been running, then we can get an idea whether this thing can be avoided or not.
Morning,
morning.
I have introduced one
call. That's all. Yeah, I know the situation because I've been there before. You know, the training also, they ask you to do this, they ask you to send a report, everything. You know, they send you to training. During the training, they ask you to send a report. If you do that at the same time, what is defensive riding? What do you understand about defensive riding? The word defense is bertahanan, tapi if we translate into bahasa, it's berhemah, kan? It's good also, I mean. So what do you understand behind the defensive driving? Defensive driving, we give you summary here, ialah is to avoid accident or collision, even though the mistake was from the other. From other user to the mistake, we avoid. So how do we do that? If you look at the incident just now, though, the car coming up from the junction make a mistake, right? Maybe the judgment, his judgment to the car, at the point he never see the car coming. But the road also like a slope like that, maybe he cannot see the car from his point of view. But again, the car coming from that side, the white shirt guy, though, driving the car, though. I mean, the guy go very fast, 100 over kilometers per hour.
Actually, 100 miles per hour.
100 miles,
yeah. Yes, but you play, the point speed is 70 at motorway, and road single road like that, actually 30. Limit, so he's 100, 3 times the over speed.
Yes. See, so shirt guy too. He's a defensive driver. It doesn't matter if you make a mistake, he's trying to go down. But every time you approach a hazard, a junction, a corner, uphill, downhill, back road, it's a hazard. So any hazard, he can approach, we have to approach it slow, and leave hazard fast. Don't slow that way, you know. Leave the hazard. But this, I mean, that white driver, I mean, the guy with the checks, shirt, make a mistake. He stopped. He stopped at the junction without any observation, proper observation. So we try not to become like that. Okay, this is FRS rules. You have a zero tolerance of any behavior, like risk tolerance behavior. You have a risk tolerance. But in Malaysia, we are risk tolerance people. But sampai one day, during work time, driving for work, for example, and some fellow workers, you are considered as a vehicle driver, and you have some driver occasional driver. If, for example, you travel per year, it's 800 miles per year, considered as a vehicle driver, less than 800 miles per year, occasional driver. But you do more than that actually, because even though you travel, you commute from your house, from your home to workplace, and vice versa, it's more than in a month compared to a year. Example, from my experience, people staying nearby my house there in Seremban, I stay in Seremban, they were in KL. So Seremban to KL is about 60, 70 kilo juga. I mean, doing fools and walking. But again, you have this rule to control the employee that was stuck to you like when you become a morning accident. You have a handphone, no handphone while driving, right? And if you think 15 kilometers per hour, it's inside your facility, inside your installation, is that you're turning as well, and especially your seatbelt. I mean, back in my old days working, my boss had usually called them. They told me to drive to meeting. Let's say we have a week, and we just call. We pick up the call with the walk. But they all tell them because we try that. You know? So don't answer the call. Okay, you have 12 hours working. I mean, these are people work in the terminal, in the refinery, again. Or a tank truck driver, they cannot work more than 12 hours. But labor law in Malaysia allow you to work under 14 hours. 14 hours per day, per week. If you work 6 days a week, 84, 72, 84 hours. But if 12 hours, you're working 5 days a week, 6 days a week, So this, why are they having this? Because they want to control your, so that you don't get fatigued. So maximum driving hours, continuous driving, you must stop every continuous driving for 2 hours, you stop 30 minutes at least. You cannot prolong after 2 keep on driving over in 2 hours because we are time, you know, getting will start to kick me. Okay, accident statistics since this is from JKDR, the Jabatan Keselamatan Jalan Raya. Since 2008, more than 6,500 cases, average of 18 cases per day, 1.5 cases per hour. 46% contributed by motorcycle in Malaysia, that's a lot. But back from you from
India? India.
Back in India, everybody knows that. I mean, there's a lot of motorcycle, but no accident at all. And the juncture with the traffic line, people going like every time, continuously honking. People. No accident. But here in Malaysia, you do that like that, I don't know.
No, because even when I was in Thailand, very surprising, like roads are really good, but Thailand was like one among the top five countries which have most accident deaths. Mm-hmm. And 60% is from the motorbike.
Yes.
And I think in 2000...
The population is about nearly 70 million men.
Yeah.
Ours is 30 million men. But again, in Malaysia also, like, we have a lot of motorcyclists in Malaysia. They cut you from left, from right, from from. You check here. Oh, you turn like that. And some of them are like gangsters, you know.
Yes, yes. They will just shut your car.
They knock your car like that.
And so also
you
very
cannot
also
do anything.
Also
very
fast.
They hit. They knock your car. Just watch it again, and take out your green side mirror, and I'm like, it happened to me.
Yeah.
In front of a US embassy. I came up from Kelsey City, underground to get. Then you came up from the US embassy on the left. Okay, then I jammed. So I, already got chuk-chuk-chuk-chuk, then I said, what's this? You didn't block it, you didn't talk to me, I'm sitting. From here, the motorcycle. He was very angry with me. He ran there and he reached there and he said, whoa, like that. He came very close to me. Pow! I told him. They were doing, he just go like that. I can't do anything. So, but sadly, I mean, very sad. I mean, we don't want this to happen, actually. Yeah? And then 47% contributed by light vehicle. And most are better. This is what that's what you say in UK and Malaysia, we have 35 deaths per every 100,000 population. But the worst is in Zimbabwe, 75 deaths per 100,000 population. In UK, but they have 3 deaths. I mean the safest I think in UK. So what this is by mirror, this is actually Malaysia punya, I mean the study done by Veros, this is for Malaysia, 81% contributed by human error. But if you look at the US or UK punya statistic, the human error become 95%. 45% is other issues. They say human are the bigger contributor. Okay. What causes accident? What's about? What happened? I mean, distraction.
Reckless.
Misjudgment.
Careless. Reckless.
Careless. Reckless. Petty.
Not aware of others.
Not aware
of other motorcycles.
Yes. Yes. Let's see what are the causes of distraction. Right? So distraction, we have scenery distraction, weather distraction, and in-cab distraction. In-cab distraction like losing loose object. You hang people like to hang football boots.
Yeah.
And some men are tapi they go your view. They distraction because they like to gantung, I mean hang the wind chime also. Then you bring your child, your kids together, they play at the back.
You try to
multitasking.
So distraction. Then you have quite enough time. Slavery kita dengar many times we will hear after the accident when we ask why. I have not enough time. I cannot pick in time. And then attitude, try to teach someone a lesson. You know, they have been very sharp in front of you. Okay, I can do it to you also. This is what happened. Not enough space. Not allowing for other people to say. So, you say, you respect, I mean, you have responsibility, you think about them also. On top of thinking about your own safety, but this time they're not allowing you to make people do things. Make your failure. Driving impairment. Driving impairment can be intoxication. I think intoxication can be a truck driver who take over the counter medicine or prescribed by doctor. But normally you prescribe from doctor. Doctor will advise you, are you driving? You drive, don't take this medicine. But if you have to take the medicine, you ask somebody else to drive for you. They will advise you. So driving impairment. Impairment can be many things. Physical impairment or vision impairment because of your screen. Terlalu banyak club, football club, golf club, this club, this club. Tapi besar dia juga ini, you know.
Sometimes like we are, when we are too emotional, right? That time they say should not drive.
But all these issues, kalau kita tengok semua, majority are human factor. Yeah. We get the vehicle failure. Suddenly, you do your normal check before you start your journey. You check the tire pressure. You check the tire punya the groove. You check the oil. You check the radiator. You check the battery. That's all you do. Then, you're not a mechanic. That is we call it rota B. You do the rota A. Rota is ordinance, they short from the rota. So rota B is mean in the workshop. Rota is the minor checking charge, external checking. Okay, all these, they sum up 81% is contributed by human health. The rest is other things like metal, like the engineering of road. Okay. Please tell me, do you think that you are a safe driver? What are the qualities that you have? Let's say that you are a better driver than the other person. Please tell me about it.
Maybe
wrong person. Because it's
depend on
situation, information. Because sometimes I can be the same driver, sometimes can say,
but just now I said problem apa itu, I think Zul. So Zul is a better driver because he's,
Is
that the bike?
I had this experience on the motorbike.
Okay.
So motorbike, I never take any calls, any emergency call or anything. Generally, I take. If I take, I will stop the vehicle and take. And when it is like heavy rain or roads are not good, don't drive fast. or if I cannot, then I just park my vehicle and go by public transport.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay,
I think I have good awareness. I'm aware who is behind me, who is at the side. So I adapt my driving by knowing people around.
You never had any incident then?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the minor, the skip, the
I think I tend to drive according to where I am. Like, for example, if you're driving in a school area, you drive slower, more carefully. And if you're in highway, you can tend to go faster, but still according to the speed limit and whatnot.
I think schema, for the park, law abiding. So, like I said, in the UK, 70 miles per hour is motorway speed, 30 miles per hour is single lane. So I always try to abide to the law. But if the weather changes, then you have to adapt.
Yeah.
So, schema, and also, I think my mom always reminds me to do when I was driving after SPM for my father. My mom was on the road, so it's like I think my mom's message is in my head, like, here, okay. And also, signaling, I think, quite important. My bugbear is when drivers don't signal when they change, so I'll always do that, make sure that I'm informing others I'm going right, I'm going left, slowly, and no sudden movements.
So all you said just now is all covered here. So you'll be surprised what you have said just now is inside here, you know. But we just want to understand better what we should have to build ourselves to become a good driver. Yeah? What is the responsibility? I mentioned about responsibility. You have to be responsible for your own safety and also for the safety of other road users. There's so many road users there. You have children, you have motorcycle, bicyclists, you have elderly people, you have budak-budak sekolah, you have school children. And don't forget, I'm not sure whether in Malaysia, but I think in UK it's very common there, people in charge of animals, riding a horse. It's also their safety. Is your responsibility, yeah? Especially again, people you bring your children inside the car. Yes, it is your responsibility because you are holding the steering wheel. Yeah? Next, quality. We call this quality. You should have this quality. Concentration must have 100% concentration on driving. Nowadays, kita ni kan, jadi ganggu itu saja. And especially like you guys could hear your office call, you know, your boss call, or your client call, you know, you sometimes need to attend quickly. That takes away your concentration. Yeah. What helps concentration? What helps concentration? You mean eyesight, good eyesight. Good hearing, good health, of course. And then you need to have a self-discipline when you drive. You have to have a discipline of driving a vehicle, self-discipline. Yeah. So then you have a concentration. Like tadi dalam kereta ada macam-macam bunyi, you know, it's like this section tadi lah. Dekat atas highway, the billboard, the digital billboard is also distract people from concentration. It takes away our concentration, and we're supposed to be focused or concentration on the road, on the task at hand. That's what someone do. It's our job now. So we have to give 100% concentration on the driving. And then anticipation. Tadi dengar, you always get. Question the action of other users. They always question things. Say, you know, you see the traffic light, I mean the signal light, you know, one moment to the left, one moment to the right, you can see his head turning. But nowadays, because the windscreen, the screen become very dark, you cannot see people inside. You know, last time you can see too. But now most cars, they put dark thinker. So they say concentration is the key to anticipation. without concentration, you cannot anticipate. You have to expect the unexpected. Because, like, for example, behind the door, okay, the door, if you want to open the door, you have to tarik ke dalam, kan? You have to pull it inside. But you have to expect somebody leaning to the door, Jimmy. So what do? You tarik behind the door. Ada orang tak seberang dan pintu. But ada baru tarik. That's something like that. But in private world, if you reach to a blind corner in the daytime, what do you do?
Slow down,
use horn. If at night you flash the light, you put a high beam then, so that people from the other side can see, oh, there's the people coming from the back. So you expect that. I said, what happened if a telecom punya contractor doing some work on the road to, you know, the manhole, where they open the manhole, on the other side of the corner, you cannot see, and then when you reach the corner, you keep on the coming at the speed, it caught you by surprise, but then you cannot stop. So that's anticipation. The first two patients is very tough in conclusion. And then, retaliation, envy, rival, crazy, rival, become common.
Common patient.
Susah kat Malaysia tu, kan? And one more thing I should point out, macam signage kat Malaysia pun skeptik ke. Kadang bukan driver je, signage pun macam ni.
Lepas
tu dah terlepas dalam Malaysia, kan? Macam...
Saya lah patient.
The kedudukan, I mean the position of the signage sometimes wrong.
Yeah.
At the wrong point, at the wrong place. How come the junction, I think you put... you know, open the junction, you put... In KL, if you drive, you miss the junction.
Yeah.
You have to go on way, turn.
Yeah, you have to shit, but you
can. Oh,
and you don't have enough time.
Betul.
But...
be reminded.
We allow people to make mistakes. Then defensive military can. We are willing to allow people to make mistakes. So that by doing that we can control the patient. We know that people will make mistakes. Allow them to make mistakes. Confidence is the last one. Apply confidence. It's good to have confidence when you drive. People with new license, they are learner driver, L license to get. They don't build, I mean, they don't have any confidence yet. But year after year, months after months, years after year, when they start to drive, they're more hour they do in driving, their confidence will up. But it's easy to get overconfident,
right? Yeah.
Overconfidence is not good, it's bad for you because it leads to you callousness. Mm-hmm. Become callousness, and callousness will lead you to accident. So you have to have all the five qualities. This is five qualities, then you become a good driver. Having you miss one of these, you can become a killer on the road. Licensed killer.
James Bond.
You have license to drive, but actually you kill people.
Yeah, betul. Yang confident tu betul juga related to signage tu lah. Kalau tu lepas jangsi tak apa. Confident until next one. So, aku patient.
To adjust your patient.
Ah.
Okay, risk and hazard. And I believe this is normally for you guys, kan? You always up to the company always drumming on you as a we do think.
Yeah, safety.
Safety, kan? So example, as a tadi ada cakap, junction is a hazard, weather is kalau heavy rain ke panas ke program ke hari gliding in front is also a hazard. Downhill, uphill, hazard. Hazard is actually to avoid you from going straight. In junction, you have to stop. Kalau red light, kalau tak ada red light pun, you have to stop. without the traffic light, kalau dia, if they have a white line, a stop line, the law say you have to stop. So because of that, it become a hazard. Lagi satu, apa itu, what is hazard, what is risk. I give you another example. In the sea, there is a shark. Jaws. Jaws is hazard or double risk? Jaws, apa itu, shark tadi, inside the sea, inside the ocean, adakah dia, is it a hazard atau a risk?
A risk.
Because hazard.
But risk related to probability.
Probability, okay.
Is it?
Okay, shark inside the sea too is hazard. Because once we get ourselves into the sea,
then it
becomes a risk. Risk or?
Kena makan lah.
Tapi selagi you ada atas darat, whenever you in the apa tu onshore, you not getting into the sea, it still remains as a hazard, but it's not a
risk. Ramai dan ramai engineer ni, someone used to tell me risk is hazard times probability.
Yeah.
So that's the equation. The risk macam isu bila kat luar laut kita tak ada risk, tapi once masuk laut probability nak termakan, so it's risk.
Macam you punya golok, parang golongan. Kalau di dalam sarung, dia adalah?
Yes.
Dia adalah hazard. But once you take out from the sarung, you dah expose dia punya mata pisau tu, mata parang tu. Dia punya risk is terluka lah. Dia macam kita kan. So in driving world, dia punya hazard ialah moving object, faulty traffic light, dark area, people. We also hazard when we interrupt. We also become hazard to other users. Eh? Road condition, risk pula, accident, fatality, death, permanent disability, loss of loved one, property damage, and injury. Risk while driving, inilah permanent disability, loss of income, and you have a disability. You don't want you to work anymore. Then, property damage, that this is based on that. Key to avoid risk and hazard, we use a traffic light concept, red light, SS. What could go wrong? What is the worst thing that can happen if something does go wrong? Ask yourself. And then hijau, we do analyze. What is something go wrong? Are we? Do we have knowledge to do this? Do we have experience of driving this type of vehicle, for example? And then the last one is action. Action, what should I do? Like example, in traffic light, intersection traffic light. Red is stop, yellow is ready to stop, green is
can go.
Right? But actually, dia kena sambung sikit. I mean, you have to add go to go if the situation is safe. For example, people always fighting for right of way lah. Macam tadi bila contoh like the accident happened earlier just now in the video, one bug came out from the junction and then the other one hit the car. If dalam junction, inside the junction is not safe, you don't go over, even though you have a payment, even though you have a right of way, you still don't go. Until it's clear, until it's safe, then where you go. Okay, if you look at this picture, what can you see in this picture? This is a one-way street. I believe this is from Penang, dekat Penang kot, sebab Pilih Penang. I don't know, maybe Melaka pun so like this. So what are the things that you can identify it? Let's say you are driving through this alley, through this street.
Someone opening the door.
Yeah. Suddenly open door.
People suddenly kids. Kids cross the road.
Yeah. A lot of things you can think. There's normally we will say, you check, you see any sign of life. Sign of life, we need to say, if you can see the light, it's on. There's a people behind you. If you don't see the light also, there may be in between the car, and the Buddha today. They said sometimes this also can become a hazard, this lantern double, you know, and so then it can fall down. So this is how we look hazard and risk. All these are hazard. They become risk when we use this. Okay? Up to here, any questions? Sections to let you know all what is happening around Kita. So the next is I'm going to introduce the WIM defensive riding technique. Now we have four principles. By applying these four principles in your driving, you can actually make a space for yourself for unexpected action by others, and time, space and time, because the time and space is very important when you drive. You know, the space is your way out. Space and visibility. Okay, principle one, look ahead. Principle two, scan and analyze. Principle three, create a space. And principle four, see. Let's talk about them individually. Let's talk about them individually. Look ahead. They will look far, very far, more than 30 seconds. This is called the eyes, lips, time. That's a bunch of formula. What is the ELT? You sit there, you can see me now. I'm in your future. For you to reach to me will take several seconds, depend on your walking speed, your driving speed. So Gurulang, I mean the eagle, because they fly very, very fast, and then they want to catch their we are free, without hitting any, and when they die down, they don't hit any trees, you know, any whatever lah. Because they can, their early time is very far. What about do turtle need to look or to see?
No.
Like what eagle do?
No.
Why?
Speed. Very slow, right?
Very slow. Very slow. Sorry. So their ID time, their ELT is less than 1 second. Less than 1 second. Because they walk very slow. If they hit anything, so they won't be hurt because they are arm already. Okay. Another comparison is the human. When we born and we start to walk, our early time is between 3 to 6 seconds. Our early time is 3 to 6 seconds. All this early time, if you can understand this, without the early time, we can survive. Okay? Naturally, they need the early time to survive. This is natural thing happened to us. Like we have this early time built in ourselves, built in the ego, built in the turtle. So they need this early time to survive. But human being, we have 3 to 6 seconds, but we don't look far, we just look up. Can I panggil department tangkap? Can I call you? Yeah. Right here. Okay, never mind. You stand here also, okay. Okay, I want you to look at the where the ceiling meets the wall. The line.
Yeah.
Look at the line there. You just look at the line. Can you see my handphone on the floor?
Yes.
Look, you can see the,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But it's not clear.
No.
But you still can see.
I can see some obstacles there.
Good. Look at my handphone.
Yeah.
Can you see where you look just now? The line?
No.
You cannot see it, okay?
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, sir. So, if you look far, you can see low. If you look low, you cannot see far. So what is related here? I'm trying to tell you is we have 3 to 6 seconds built in ourselves, but now we are driving a vehicle. Our walking speed is about 4 to 5 kilometers per hour. Average, 45 kilometers per hour. But when we drive, we go how fast?
70, 80,
110, 260. F1 driver? Gigantos?
Oh, yeah.
Right? Do you think 3 to 6 seconds enough?
No.
For you to see? So you have to what?
Increase.
We recommend you to increase another 9 seconds to become at least 15 seconds. 15 seconds. How do you see 15 seconds? 15 seconds on the highway is about 1 kilometer. On the street, in the city driving, you look at 2 blocks of building. The end of the second block of the building, that's where you have to look. Why? Because if you look far, you can see low. If you look low, you cannot see far, right? So this is what we look, okay? Look as far as 15 seconds. And then, do not look down. When I look down, you look straight up, set your eye high, tilt your head like that, the chances are when your eyes fall down, they start fall down. So if you bring down your head like that, the chances of your eye to drop down much easier. Eh? They will drop lagi kan. So you know, when you tak nampak jauh. When you tak nampak jauh, when you cannot see far, that is where the statement go. I have not enough space. I have not enough time. But by looking, how can we look 15 seconds if we do not have a correct following distance? Example, apa tu, apa nama dia? Barat. Barat tengah drive. Okay, you tengah drive. You're driving now. You are following a container truck ataupun a big high profile vehicle lah. At this distance, you can see, your eyesight can see, you can see bigger, right? You can see bigger, right? But what happened when you drive to the back? What happened to the back of the vehicle? Your eye will be limited, your visibility will be limited. What do you see?
Back of the truck.
What do you do to get your visibility back, to gain your visibility? What do you do? Slowing down. Okay, now, when you slow down, you get the speed that you can. Itu tak. Tapi kalau kereta, macam ni, with this distance, with this following distance, you can see big picture. But when you follow close to the back of the vehicle, what do you see? Who's driving for you now? Who is driving for you now?
The car in front.
When you turn, you break, you know? He's doing the driving for you. It's not supposed to be like that. Huh? You have to do, you have to drive yourself. Huh? Even a motorcycle, walaupun dia kecil, even though it's small on the road, motorcycle always on the left, on the left most lane ataupun something, the middle lane.
Or on the line.
On the line. But if you follow too closely to the vehicle, what do you do? What happened to your eye? What happened to your eye? Mata you nak kena tengok, takut terlanggar dia dah. Bila you tengok dia, it denies you from looking far. So what do you do to avoid all this thing is
four seconds.
We recommend 4 seconds now. I mean, maybe before this you have attended different punya defensive driving. They said 2 seconds. Have you heard about 2 seconds rule? And then you also have 3 seconds rule. But we recommend 4 seconds. Why 4 seconds? Actually, you. How to count for second following distance? This is you, this is us, and you are following one car. Mark one object that doesn't move, a fixed object, like for example, this is a signboard. You can use 3D, you can use a speed light, pole, anything that doesn't move. Even the on the road to the signage, arrow, anything, you can use that as a reference point. When the front vehicle reach to that point, you start to count 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004. Once your car, until you reach it by counting 1004, that means you have 4 seconds behind that car, the blue car. But remember, you cannot get every time prolonged, but during the drive through, you have 4 seconds. Huh? If you lose the 4 seconds, work to get it back. People will have some mind that, they have inside their mind that when they allow, when you have a space like that, what happened?
Somebody else will
occupy your space. Yeah. You will lose 1 second or you will lose 2 seconds, right? And then you're slowing down, it's from your gas pedal, you want to get the 4 seconds there. But people think that, oh, I'm going backward. Actually, you are going forward, but you feel like you are going backward because somebody cut in. hello, for example, you drive from KL to, for example, to Malaysia, yeah? How many times that thing happen, you have to build the space, how many times? Because every time people cut into your, occupy your space, you lose 1 second. So you build another space, 4 second. You lose 1 second, 1 second. If 10 times, or 10 seconds, you lose. People think that every time people up to any other car, occupy the space, they think that they are very late. They are, I mean, they will reach to the destination late. But actually, if you complete, you only lose a few seconds. So why is 4 seconds? 1 second is you see the problem. Mind works when you see a problem. Another second, your action, break, or change lane. Okay. Lepas tu, you need the, if you break, if this car suddenly emergency brake, then you have 2 seconds to stop your vehicle. That's why you need 4 seconds. Now 2 seconds, you detect the problem and you take the action, bomb. 3 seconds also not enough to stop behind this car. Brake is only to stop the wheel spin, the rotation of the wheel. But the car is still moving, eh? Tire touch your car, tapi. So this is how you calculate the pulling distance. I think in the practical session there, we'll show you, I'll demonstrate to you how to build a 4 second pulling distance. Okay? But remember, this 4 second, you always come 4 second at any speed. Even in the traffic jam also. Because by color traffic jam, you're moving very slow. Your space 4 second is maybe from here to the wall side here. Why? Because time to tick at the natural pace, kan? They can go slow, they can go fast. But the speed, have a slow, the distance between you and the front vehicle will be short, will be shorter if you go slow. If you go fast, you become bigger. So but if we faster, you quicker reach to the point. You get me? Yeah. Okay. This is how to come, 1001, 1001, ataupun 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, dulu my guru ajar like that. Dia from Mississippi, Tennessee, dia pun boleh buat negara dia. Okay, principle one, I think, okay. This is normally what people will do when they drive over visibility in that time. They always look where the light spray. Their eye will focus only at where the light spray. But if that's the time you say, you have to explore into it beyond the light. Don't focus until theory, beyond the light. And if bad weather, night time, you increase the pulling distance to 5 or 6 or 7. The more, it's a little better. Yeah. This is the graph of the speed versus how far the vehicle stop at 32 km per hour, 5 meter to stop the vehicle, at 48 km per hour, 11 meter, at 64, 20, and so on, so on. Yeah. This is on a flat road, on a dry surface, on a wet surface, and the gradient, then the distance will be very tight. Yeah. So here, how do we look far? We maintain our pulling distance. We look the front meter, we look to the side, emerging traffic, this is emerging. The car from here will merge into our lane. And then we focus as far we can see. Why we look far? Because we want to avoid any conflict. Before you become conflict, kita tengok dulu, kita dapat dulu. principle number two, scan and analyze. I want you to draw the line, to connect the line from 1, 8, follow the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But I just start you put the line. I give you 15 seconds to draw the line, to carry the number from 1, as many as you can. Okay. Start now. Okay, stop. How much? How many you get?
Lapan.
Four.
Five.
Six and a half.
Six and a half.
Seven.
Five. Okay, now you turn the page. Fold the paper. Fold it like that. And open back the other side. I can get the line. Now, on your left hand side of the paper two is odd number. On the right hand side is even number. Now you know, you tell your brain where to search for.
Exactly.
Yeah, I give you same time juga, 15 saat, daripada from now, start. Stop. Still dapat lebih daripada tadi. You get more than the first try. Right? Yeah. What is related to this defensive driving? Kan? I mean, in your driving world, you can see many things on the road, huh? But you need to select the relevant object and avoid to see non-relevant object while you drive. Non-relevant object is something that is on the other side of the road, like a coffee shops, people are having coffee on the other side of the road, but on the other side of the road. So you don't have to give attention to them. Your intention is here, right? So you have to select them between the important and non-important, relevant and non-relevant. Okay. So you need to move your eye. Then you know, then you tell to yourself, okay, this is not relevant, so you can adjust your eye to see. Constant eye movement every 2 seconds. If you focus your eye more than 2 seconds, there are two things happen. I mean, one thing happen actually. Stare, they call it stare. In stare, we have two types of stare. One is blank stare, the other one is fixed stare. Fixed stare means you only see one object, your mind focus on one object. But blank stare, like a daydreaming, huh? Happened to you when you drive going back from work, back to home, and you miss a junction. It happened, huh? It happened to me, it happened very early, because suddenly when we drive, because we're tired, or maybe, think about home, think about work, then your mind going somewhere else, it's not focused on the driving. This is what happened, and you miss the junction. So to avoid that, you have to move your eye every 2 seconds. Yeah. I think you need to know, we have two types of vision, central and also peripheral. Yeah. Let's see. So you need to check. check your mirror. So how many mirrors do we have in our car? Three mirrors. Side mirror, three left and right. And then you have a rear view mirror inside, internal, and around. So to check the mirror 5 to 8 seconds is to get the surrounding that you want to know surrounding. Because by sitting, when you drive, you look far, you look in front, you use your vision at the front, because this is direct view, direct vision. So if you use the mirror, it means you use the indirect view. Because we cannot see at the back, at the rear side, with the mirror. Don't stay there, I'll take more than 2 seconds. How do you adjust your mirror? How do you adjust the mirror? How do you like to adjust your mirror?
Yeah,
you want to see more of the car, or you want to see more of the road?
Road.
Yeah. Right here we recommend, we recommend you need to adjust 20-80. But if you, if you happen to know that Ford Motor Company, they come up with how to adjust the mirror. Have you seen that before? So when you sit in the car, you adjust this right mirror to sampai your car body ni sampai tembus ke sini je. More on the outside. Why we want to reduce the blind spot? Yeah. This side, how you adjust this side? Because this is on the left hand side.
Inside.
You stay in the right most in the car, yeah? So you have to lean your body to the center and you adjust until the mirror macam ni. And you can see more on the outside.
Sometimes they put the round thingy at the
round thing, wide angle, ataupun fish eye ke apa benda tu kan. But that one, I don't think it can help, sir, because it's very small.
Very small, yeah.
Mm. Kalau dia besar sikit, okay. Okay, this is the blind area, blind spot of the car. Yeah, you cannot see the motorcycle even though it's very close to you, but you cannot see when they go into your blind area. You go into the spot with the one car can hide inside the blind area. Yeah, mirror, you have to check the mirror, check the signal, and then look over the shoulder. We have the technique of checking the mirror. This is basically the routine of every junction, every roundabout. When we approach roundabout, when we approach junction, first of all, we have to check mirror. Second, you have to give signal. Third, you have to maneuver. Inside the maneuver is position, speed, load. This is the procedure of taking the junction ataupun taking a MSM piece. Now remember that MSM PSL. MSM mirror signal maneuver. Inside the maneuver you have position speed loads. So when you see something in the mirror, just looking is not enough. Driver must give themselves time to act on what they see in their mirrors. When you see something in the mirror, you have to give your because mirror doesn't tell exactly the object. Sometimes they tell you they are far away, but actually they are very close to you. If you think what you're doing, then you